So recently, I have started getting into an arcade game on the Hive called Block Drop, thanks in large to an absolutely wonderful person I had the pleasure of talking with the other day, and to be frank, it has been a very fun experience. So much so that I actually ended up playing it until 2 a.m. despite the fact that I had work at 6 that same morning. And I know I always will be a Block Party main at heart, but hey, who's to say that I can't excel at other game modes? And when you think about it, Block Party has indirectly trained me to be good at making jumps from block to block, and the concept of floors disappearing is all too familiar to me, so adjusting to Block Drop's mechanics were more seamless for me than most. And before anyone asks, yes, I know this is just TNT Run, but honestly, Block Drop's mechanics are, to me, way more interesting with block decay and good pacing with removing the top floors after an allotted time frame. You also have the resources to recover from mistakes or just relocate to more optimal floors if you really need it. And I know that in a lot of my recent videos, I have been slamming certain individuals for what I can honestly call neglect at best. But block decay and feathers are actually pretty balanced and only enhances the experience as a whole. But that won't stop me from making a suggestion or two to opinionatedly enhance the block drop experience based on my own. Firstly, let's get some context out of the way. Block drop is usually comprised of four floors with one exception. The first floor is basically meaningless in the long run, with the second floor not being too important either, but still being the first floor you would rather try to stay on for as long as possible. Floor 3 and 4 are the more critical floors that require genuine focus and concern for position. The game throws a lot of randomized power-ups at you, and the only one I care for is the Nemo Slapper, which is by far the most powerful item you can acquire. And when I say a lot, I mean like 20 plus over the course of a game. But one of the things this game struggles with on the higher levels of play is how impactful power-ups are. But the power-ups themselves spawn on random floors and give random items. Let me throw you a scenario. Let's say you spend the entire game on the highest floors, meanwhile everyone else is below you and the power-up system throws all the power-ups at them. They last long enough for you to reach their level and they use 15 Nemo Slappers to finish you off. You did everything right and still lost due to the incredible power of factors you did not have control over. Which is why I would like to recommend a system that places higher power-up priority on the highest floor while still occasionally dropping power-ups on the lower ones. This way, the higher floors have more value and importance. Furthermore, for those of you who might think that it would be broken due to how many power-ups the top players would get, you'd be wrong, since you can use feathers to navigate from floor to floor. So if someone is on the lower floor and chooses to not try to navigate to a higher floor to increase their odds, that is on them. My suggestion, I believe, would help with consistency in a game where power-ups hold so much power. Too much power, if you ask me. And speaking of power-ups, Block Party's power-up system is just as powerful, if not more. Because unlike Block Drop, where you have 4 to 5 chances to recover, albeit some of those scenarios you are forced to level down anyways, on Block Party, you only have one fragile life with no feather to recover. The suggestion I made for Block Drop's power-up system allows for the attaining of power-ups to be more skill-based and fair. It's not perfect, but it more effectively rewards skill. I would like to see something similar to Block Party, with either the option of a voting system that removes power-ups or a system that rewards power-ups to players that perform certain actions. For example, let's say the game picks a color and you get to the spot without moving the longest compared to your opponents. If you perform this task 3 times in a game, you are rewarded with a power-up. This system helps the skilled players who understand positioning and makes them the most likely to get power-ups, but it's not a perfect system either. And while we're talking about the importance of power-ups, I would like to suggest 2 things to make power-ups less powerful should the power-up system in Block Party remain as I fear it will be, as it is in Block Drop now. First, add a cooldown to the use of power-ups so you can only use 1 power-up per floor or something to that degree. I cannot stress enough that you should not, under any circumstance, be able to spam power-ups to survive a floor. The second recommendation is nerfing the inevitable addition of the Ender Pearl power-up by making the death feel below the map be closer to the floor itself, maybe by as little as a 10-block difference. This way, the overpowered aspects of the Ender Pearl are heavily nerfed, and you could even say that the feather would be a stronger item. Oh, and one more thing before I wrap this video up. Please keep the selected block in the 5th inventory slot, and also add a toggleable player transparency item. Thanks. So yeah, believe it or not, I don't really have a whole lot left to talk about when it comes to Block Party. I've basically covered everything I could possibly think of. Pacing, power-ups, leaderboards. By the way, you won't have to worry about that section. The leaderboards will be fine. Map production and community assistance, luck versus skill, asymmetry, skill ceiling. All of these videos are meant to educate on just how complex a game like Block Party really is. And I really want to see it come to fruition as its best possible version of any other. I love this game mode, and I know others will too. Heck, we got a whole community of people just waiting to get their hands on this game once it releases. So yeah, that's all I got for you today. Thanks, and have a good one. Later, peoples. I'm running cross country to get it, but it's mine. It's mine. Oh, who am I doing this to? I don't even care. Who am I doing this to? NSK! Come here, bro! Come here! Come here! Come here! I have a gift for you! I'm gonna go ahead and just come here! Come here, bro! Come here, buddy! Come on! What's there to be afraid of, buddy? Ah! Oh, no! Worth it! Worth every block! Oh my god, oh my god, jeez, help me, oh my, two, four block jumps in a row, oh my god, why, just give me something, I'm in my final stretch. Okay. Here we go, baby. Hey! Yes! We're cool, you know? Everything's fine. No, but no hard feelings. It's fine, you know. Just guys being guys. You know how it is sometimes. You know? Hey! Uh-oh! I fell down. I almost died again. Okay. Somebody tells me I'm about to get assassinated. I have, like, no power-ups. And it's just me and him. Oh, God. I'm so dead. He's got a Nemo. Go ahead, slap me. Slap me. You won't do it. You won't. You won't do it. You won't do it. Oh, okay. Yeah. You won't do it. All right, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Oh my god! I'm so dead. I am completely out of space. Nope. No. Oh. No. Yes. Come on. Go ahead, do it! Do it! You won't! You won't! You won't! Yep, go ahead! Do it! Do it! Oh, no, sir! No, sir! Sorry, what was that? Were you trying to slap me with your Nemo? Huh? I know you got still got another one, too. Go ahead, do it! You won't! Do it! Hit me! You won't do it. Come on! Yes! Yes! I'm so good! I'm so good. So impossibly good at this game. Can I get, like, one power-up that will actually... I need to use another feather. Can I get, like, one power-up, please, that'll help... Where is he? You're mine, buddy! You're mine! You hear me? You're done! You're freaking done! Ah! Yes! I would have died right there! Yes! No! Go ahead, hit me! You won't! You won't! He's running! End him! Right here! No! Yeah!